There's this quote that starts to make the rounds right near the beginning of every World Cup. It's from former England striker Gary Lineker. Football is a simple game. 22 men chase a ball for 90 minutes, and at the end, the Germans always win. Well, the Germans don't always win, though they do win a lot, and soccer isn't a simple game. The process of moving the ball 100 yards downfield with your feet through a crowd of 11 other men and into a 24-by-8-foot goal requires an incredible amount of team-wide coordination, pre-planned strategy, and on-the-fly thinking. That's why conversations about the sport can often sound like something out of an Italian algebra class.
Well, actually, you need two Medio Volantes if you want to play a 3-5-2 with a Regista, but I guess you already knew that.
But at the core of all that complexity, soccer is just a game about defending one side of a rectangle and attacking the other. In that way, it's actually a not-too-distant cousin of football or basketball. So, if you're worried about wrapping your head around what you see on the field in Russia this summer, don't fret. All you have to do is remember three things that you already know. The Patriots, the Warriors, and the Rockets. Football, like soccer, is a battle for space. Over the past two seasons, the New England Patriots have given up a ton of yards, but they've still ranked near the top of the league in points allowed. Why? They don't really care about defending anywhere on the field other than the end zone. Soccer purists might hate it, but New England's approach isn't that much different from the concept of parking the bus. It goes like this. Rather than defending the entire field, less talented teams drop all 11 players behind the ball and defend the plot of grass directly in front of the goal. If you can hold the Falcons to a field goal every time they have the ball, you do it. The same goes for forcing Neymar and Brazil to pile up shots from 25 yards out. However, the best teams will push high up the field and try to pressure their opponents into a turnover. Your Germanys and your Spains of the world will leave lots of space in behind their defenses for two reasons. One, the risk is outweighed by the potential of a turnover close to the other team's goal. And two, they have defenders who function like free safeties. What that means is they're reading the play and deciding whether to charge forward to make a tackle or drop back to deal with a deep ball. Germany's Mats Hummels has a similar job to, say, someone like Seattle's Earl Thomas. Of course, the difference is Thomas doesn't also have to play offense after he intercepts a pass. When Hummels gets the ball, he immediately turns into a quarterback. Or maybe we should call him a point guard. Basketball has undergone a positional revolution. On the Golden State Warriors, Draymond Green is a 6'7" center who would have been a small forward 15 years ago. And Kevin Durant is a 6'9" power forward who plays like a shooting guard. In soccer, center backs like Hummels are now expected to pass like midfielders, while attackers like Belgium's Kevin De Bruyne, Brazil's Felipe Coutinho, and Colombia's James Rodriguez, those guys are now getting squished back into the midfield in order to fit more goal-scoring talent into the lineup. Case in point, when they announced their roster for Russia, Germany listed their midfielders and their forwards together as one group. This year, the Houston Rockets became the first team in NBA history to take more threes than twos. Because, well, you get it. While soccer teams are still way behind on the path to analytical enlightenment, they are starting to understand the importance of shot quality. Remember the attacking midfielders we told you about? Thanks to them, their teams now have the personnel to create those good shots too. In the Premier League, the distance from goal on the average shot has dropped in each of the past five seasons. It's just logical. It's easier to score when you're closer to the goal. The trend was perhaps best embodied by league champion Manchester City. With a squad that featured players who will suit up for Germany, Argentina, Brazil, England, Belgium, Spain, France, and Portugal at the World Cup, City took the highest quality shots in the league, which led to a league record 106 goals in just 38 games. In other words, the best offense in the league was also the most efficient. So, when you sit down to watch the World Cup this summer, make sure you keep those three things in mind: space, positional flexibility, and shot quality. This way, if Germany do end up restoring Lineker's equilibrium, well, at least you'll know why, even if you can't pronounce Catenaccio. We'll be right back.